I'm Adam Steinfurth with sheetshelp.com, and we're going to go through a horizontal XLOOKUP. So you may have used XLOOKUP before, and if you have, you've probably used it to look down a column and then return a value from another column. We're going to go through two examples of how to look through rows and return values from other rows. So this first example, and all these examples are going to be available, I'll put a link in the description of the video so you can make a copy of this spreadsheet and follow along. Do the exact same thing I'm doing. But we will go to the first example where we're looking for the name of Richard. So if you look at the syntax, we're going to type XLOOKUP and then the search key will be Richard. So that's the value that we're going to search for. So let's type that much and then we'll go back to that syntax. Let's say XLOOKUP. The search key, so we want to look up Richard. Richard is already typed into this spreadsheet. That value lies in cell B5. So we'll click on B5, that puts that cell reference into the formula. We'll enter a comma, and then it's looking for the lookup range, and that's Google Sheets just saying, where should I look for this value? Tell me where to look. So instead of specifying a column, we're going to specify a row, and we want to look at B14 through E14. I'll just do that with my mouse. So I will click and drag until I get to the end of that range. That's all for the lookup range. Now that we specified the lookup range, we want to tell the function where the results are. So that'll be the result range. So we will type a comma. Let's go over to the reference here. We typed in the search key, the lookup range. Now we're going to type in the results range, which is, you want to return the region. We're looking for the region, so we will come over and specify with our mouse B15 through E15. We'll close that off. That XLOOKUP function is done. And what it did, it looked in the row 14 for Richard and returned south from row 15. That's what that is. All right, we'll do one more example that's going to give us a little bit of repetition, and then we'll have a twist to see something else we can do with XLOOKUP. So let's say we want to look for Richard again, but there are two values we want to return. So there can be as many as you want, but in this case, we'll say we're looking for Richard. So that'll be, we'll look in the same lookup range, but the results range will be two rows. And it's relatively intuitive how to do this. So we're going to type the equal sign again. You always type equals before a function. XLOOKUP. The search key will be the same. It's going to be Richard, and this time it's in B26. Hit the comma. The lookup range will be the same thought process as the first example. This is the row that contains the search key, right? And then the results range, though, we'll just extend it to two rows and then drag the mouse over. So we'll specify that by saying B34:E35, right? B34 is in the upper left-hand corner of the cell reference, and the lower right-hand corner is E35. We will type a parentheses to indicate that we're done with the function and hit return. And it's important to notice that this function returned an array. So that means that it returned more than one value. So it's spilled, the function is only typed into B28. But it spilled its result into B29 as well. So be careful, because if you have something in a cell that might get overwritten, so we'll just put some X's into B29, you'll get an error on the function. So you have to make sure you have a clear space for it to write into. So we will delete that. If you want to learn more, this next video will walk you through more examples. Thanks for watching.